النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he says that لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله باب من أبواب الجنة. It's a door of the doors of the paradise. Meaning anyone who says it, it'll make the worship easy for him, and as a result, the door of the paradise opens for him. النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he says لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله كنز من كنوز الجنة. That it is a treasure, a chest of the treasures of the paradise. What does that mean? That you know the entire paradise is a treasure. But when النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says that this word is a treasure in the paradise, meaning is it is a treasure compared to the treasure that's already in the paradise. And you understand something. يعني معناته its reward is huge. That's what it means. That the reward of this word is so huge. It's a door of the paradise on its own for the one who continuously used to say it. وَكَنْزٌ مِنْ كُنُوزِ الْجَنَّةِ. You know a kanz, a treasure box. What's in a treasure box? What's inside a treasure box? Money, gold, valuable gold. It's already collected for you. You don't have to collect it. In other words, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. العلماء رحمهم الله, they said this one phrase collects a lot of meanings within it. When you say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, it affirms the fact that you are relying on Allah Azza wa Jal. There's reliance of Allah inside this statement. When you say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, تدل على الافتقار إلى الله. It also implies that you are acknowledging your weakness before Allah Azza wa Jal. There's so many meanings within لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. والنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم he says in a hadith that لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله تحت العرش. It's underneath the عرش. طيب, I ask you a question. What's written on top of the عرش? And pay attention so you can learn something incredible in this. What's written on top of the arsh? Who knows? There's something written on top of the arsh. Allah wrote it and it's a book and He stored it on top of the arsh. It's a few words. Allah Azza wa Jal wrote, Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi. That's on top of the arsh. It means Allah Azza wa Jal said, my mercy precedes my anger. My mercy overrides my anger. That's on top of the arsh. Underneath the arsh, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. What's the relationship between the two? On top of the arsh, Allah is teaching us how He deals with the servants. How He deals with us. He deals with us with mercy and compassion. And under the arsh, what is written is how we are supposed to deal with Allah. And that is that we cannot do anything except with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help and aid and support. From the dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to say, Allahumma hdini, oh Allah, guide me. He didn't used to stop there. He used to say, wa yassiri al-huda li, and make guidance easy for me. So you know, for us, a lot of the times it's very easy that we ask Allah azza wa jal to make our worldly life matters easy. You're going through a difficulty. You see a brother, make dua that Allah makes it easy for me. Someone is struggling to get married. Brother, ask Allah that He makes it easy for me. Someone is going to court tomorrow. Brother, please don't forget me in your dua. Make dua that Allah makes it easy for me. Someone's going through financial difficulty. Oh Allah, make my affairs easy for me. That's good. That's required. But what about your worship? How come the 100 Salat al-Fajr you missed, you didn't even care to ask after it, oh Allah, help me to get up for Salat al-Fajr. And the Quran that you're reading, and you keep stuttering, and you just gave up. Why didn't you ask Allah to make Al-Quran easy for you to read? Why didn't you ask Allah Azza wa Jal ease in Islamic religious matters? Why is it always asking Allah ease in this worldly life? You know why? لأن the heart has been corrupted. خلاص. The heart only looks at worldly matters. That's all it's caring about. And the bottom line honesty is we don't care about the worship. We don't care. If we cared, we would have asked. We would have said, وَهْدِنِي وَيَسِّرِ الْهُدَى لِي. Make guidance easy for me. Make it easy upon me that I get up and attend Salat al-Jama'ah and pray with the congregation of the Muslims. Make it easy for me that I continue my fasting after Ramadan. How come that's not included in the dua? Then we need to learn that this is supposed to be an integral part of our life, that we continuously and consistently ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He help us and aid us in our worship.